Si Pangulong Duterte, wala ba siya ngayong Lenten message, Bombo Raymond? Dahil inaabangan nito nung isang araw pa nung ating mga kababayan.
Negative. Kanina pa tayo at actually kahapon pa tayo nag-aabang Bombo Dennis, eh, no? At walang mensahe o Lenten message si Pangulong Duterte na usually ay audio video na ipinapadala sa mga mamahayag. Pero ngayong taon ay wala. So baka naman sa Easter Sunday na yung kanyang magiging mensahe, ha, kung meron. Pero may nakatakdang pagpupulong pa ang Interagency Task Force bukas, Black Saturday o Sabado de Gloria, kung saan ay tatalakayin yung mga panukala na i-extend or palawigin ng 1 to 2 weeks pa ang ECQ sa tinatawag na NCR Plus Bubble o yung Metro Manila, Laguna, Rizal, Bulacan at Cavite. So doon maisapinal yung mga rekomendasyon at saka ipapaprubahan sa Pangulo dahil siya pa rin ang final say. At malalaman natin siguro ng kinagabihan ng Sabado o Linggo, depende sa kung ano yung urgency ng magiging rekomendasyon at approval decision ng Pangulo Bombo Dennis.
I joined the Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission as it launches Project Kasangga Tukhan Laban sa Korupsyon. Let me express my full support for this project, which is consistent with my administration's goal of ensuring transparency and accountability in government. I hope this project will encourage all of us in government to set aside our personal interests so that we may instill a culture of decency, integrity, and honesty in public service. I wish you a meaningful event.
I, as PACC Chairman, would like to restate its commitment to President Duterte's campaign promise to rid this government of graft and evildoers. We wish to remind everyone that public office is a public trust. Wala nang lingunan sa manangyari noon. Pero, anything from this point onward, anyone engaging in graft, one strike po tayo. We will know, we will press all our powers and authority to make sure, as instructed by the President, no one gets away with these illegal activities. I urge all of you to toe the line. Please toe the line. Project Kasangga has the following objective. First, engage the active participation of all government officials on PIRD's anti-corruption advocacy in partnership with the PACC. Establishment of anti-corruption focal person office for coordinated speedy detection, prosecution, and resolution of graft and corruption cases with the agency or department. Second, cascading a God-centered anti-corruption advocacy to the lowest unit of the agency through education, seminars, and trainings, and renewing of our pledge of service by inking manifesto of cooperation and the oath of honesty. Third, institutionalization of a simplified and streamlined system and processes for the reduction of corruption incidents, which includes IT-based command centers, infrastructure for joint monitoring of critical corruption-prone offices. It's either you are with government or against government. Your choice. So then, let us ink the manifesto of our pledge of commitment and oath of honesty by the help of God. Yan pong mahigpit na utos sa amin ng ating Pangulo at ng mga taong binabanggit. Puro ho ng loloko lang yan mga yan. Puro lang pansarili yan. Pag nahuli po namin kayo, pasensyahan po talaga tayo. Gagawin po namin ang trabaho namin. Kaya po hinihimok namin kayo na magtulungan na lang po tayo. Yung mga nangyari noon, ulitin ko lang po, yung mga nangyari noon, hindi ko na po hukayin yun. Pero todalain tayo ngayon. And anything, any graft and corruption you do today, hindi ko talaga namin kayo patatawarin. This manifesto will commit ourselves. Number one, free from corruption activities. Number two, that we commit to combat corruption in our own districts and offices. Number three, that we will cooperate with government in combating corruption. Number four, that we will remain loyal to our oaths of offices. Number five, that we will inform government through PACC of all corrupt activities that come to our knowledge. And lastly, failure to fulfill our part in this manifesto should mean voluntary resignation from our office, and may the curse of the Lord be upon us. Ladies and gentlemen, let us ink this paper from our heart. Alam ko po, mahirap. Pero pag humingi tayo ng tulong sa Diyos at sa Kanyang grasya, kaya po natin yan. Ang ending po nito, mas mataas na koleksyon at revenue para sa ating bansa. Malilinis natin ang ating bureau ng corruption or perception of corruption. Yung mga tinatrabaho nating magaganda na ginagawa naman dito talaga sa customs ay hindi natin matatabunan ng putik. At we can be proud that in this generation and in our time, we did something good and we made an impossible become into reality. And that is because of you. The privilege to work in government has its conditions for continuing employment in accordance with specific laws, rules, and regulation. Let us not wait that our attention are called to be reminded of the sworn duties and obligations. We know how things operate in your agency. Now is the time to clean up. The remaining time of the president in office have been promised to be dedicated in controlling these practices of corruption in all agencies of government. Consider the PACC's program of action as a form of tokhang laban sa korupsyon under its overall project kasangga to be in effect immediately.